Hello friends, how are you all? Welcome to Buell's Kitchen. Today recipe is going to be a crab curry. Crabs are very rare to find in Ireland, but I just got it luckily, so I'm just going to show you how to make it, and it's going to be very simple and very quick. So I have taken about 1 kilo of crab, so I just washed it. It's just the legs, so just mashed it with a stick. I didn't show you how to wash it, but then I just wash it with a little bit of turmeric powder and some salt, and it's so clean now. So the next thing what you need is the ingredients what you need. I just show you what are the things we needed for crab curry. Now friends, here I have taken crab legs. This is about a kilo, and here I have some tamarind. It's kind of a lemon sized tamarind. I soaked it in the water. Next, you need some onions. Here I have taken about 30 numbers of small onions. If you have small onions, use the small onions. It will give a nice flavor for the curry. The next thing is the coriander powder and the red chilies, which I have soaked it in the warm water, and some coconut, handful of coconut. And here I have some methi seeds and fennel seeds. And here garlics, which handful of garlic. I crushed it and I kept it ready. And this is the masala, very important for crab curry. That's a tablespoon of black pepper, cumin seeds and fennel seeds. What we're gonna do is we're gonna grind the coconut as well as these three items together and grind it and keep it ready. We're gonna add it later. So next thing is we need some tomatoes. I have 4 tomatoes here, so I'm just gonna use 4 tomatoes and some curry leaves and some green chilies. So as I said, the first thing what you need to do is just grind these two items and keep it ready. And then we're just gonna squeeze the tamarind and take the tamarind water and keep it ready as well. And then I'll show you how to do it. Now friends, let's start making crab curry. So first thing, you need a big pan like this, and take a big pan and have some sesame oil. If you have some sesame oil, it will be very nice. So just add some sesame oil, about 4 tablespoons. The next thing is add some methi and then some fennel seeds. Just wait for the fennel seeds and the methi to get infused in the oil. Next, you can add your curry leaves and 2 green chili and some garlic. Now you can add your onions. I can feel the aroma, friends. It's so lovely here. Now friends, the onion has become translucent. Now we can start adding the masala powder. Here I have some coriander powder. I'm going to use about 4 tablespoons. And next thing is the turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon. Yeah, just 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric. And now the masala which we grinded with the chili. I'm going to add that as well. I'm going to add about 4 tablespoons. So give it a mix. Let the raw smell goes off. We'll fry this for a couple of minutes. Now we're gonna add the tomato puree. Just give it a mix. Look at the color, friends, how beautiful it is. Now the next thing what we're gonna add here is the tamarind water. Just gonna add the tamarind water. Now we'll add the salt. We'll add about 2 tablespoons. Give it a mix. Finally, we'll add the coconut mixture, which we grinded with pepper and the fennel seed. So give it a mix as well. Let it come to boil. Once it's come to boil, we'll add the crab, and the crab will cook very fast, friends. So we'll leave the crab for 10 minutes and then we'll switch it off. And that's our crab curry. It'll be very, very yummy with hot steamed rice. So let it come to boil now. We'll cover it and we'll cook it for 10 minutes. Now friends, the curry is getting boiled now. So this is the time we need to add the crab. So we just add the crabs here. Just leave this for 10 minutes and your curry will be ready, friends. So finally, we're just gonna garnish this with a little bit of coriander. So we're gonna eat this with hot steamed white rice. So once it's done, I'll just serve it and I'll show you, friends. Now friends, here's the hot crab curry. It's ready to eat now. You can see the color, how it is. It's so inviting and it's going to be very good for the chest infection. And you know, if you have cold, you can eat this. And thank you so much for watching my video, friends. We're gonna enjoy this for lunch. I hope you like this video. If you like it, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. We'll see you in the next video, friends. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.